Well, with Osama bin Laden, the man who triggered the so-called war on terror in Afghanistan, now dead, locals there are understandably nervous about what happens next in their battered and divided land, occupied as it still is by troops from the West, including, of course, our own, attempting to rein in Taliban insurgents. Afghan women in particular are worried. Chris Campy reports from the capital, Kabul.
The one thing that remains the same and consistent throughout is that people are more vulnerable here than in most places on earth.
The moment Barack Obama told the world his forces had killed Osama bin Laden in Pakistan, discussion returned to when the global commitment in Afghanistan will end.
It will be a nightmare for Afghan women even to think about withdrawal from international community.
One of the most popular justifications for continued international involvement here in Afghanistan was the liberation of Afghan women. Now that those governments are looking to timeframes for withdrawing, those same women fear that without such global pressure, their voices may once again soon be silenced.
This has been used as a justification for war since about 2002. We are here to protect your rights. We are here to empower you. Come out of the woodwork. Come into the public domain.
CARE International has been working in Afghanistan for 50 years, but many more non-government organisations have flooded in since the war began. Women, they say, are now in the open, vulnerable and pushing for change.
Everyone is trying to redefine how they can support those efforts in order to get the fastest possible impact to reduce the insurgency or the impact of the insurgency and get out as quickly as possible. And this is a concern because it means that funding is no longer based on what is good development practice or what is appropriate or what the people want or what the people need. It's about getting out.
Of course, there has been progress.
My grandmom and my mom had never a chance to sit with president and talk face to face and then negotiating and advocating for lobbying for women's rights. But fortunately, I, as a daughter of that nation, I have the chance to speak with cabinet, to speak with president himself. Of course, it's a big change for me.
Acelia Wardak Jamal is the Director of Human Rights and Women's Affairs inside President Hamid Karzai's government. Like many, she fled during the Taliban's rule, returning when international troops moved in.
Everybody had a fear to be arrested by Taliban or to put it in jail and publicly beaten in front of all men. But then my courage and then my parents' support were with me. And then I had a voice, of course, speaking with media and then talking with international community and then raising Afghan women's voice.
The one thing, possibly the only thing, that everyone agrees on in this country is that no one knows what the next 5 years are going to look like.
Chris Campy.